Hi, welcome to this tutorial explaining how to use the project overview in the project editor. This tutorial will be based on the Needs Space 3 project, so we open that. And when we go to the project overview, we can see we already have several items attached. Here we have an Epson projector. We have some specifications for that device. We can change the baud rate and other stuff for this device. And we have some infrared devices. We can do that as well. Then we have an amplifier attached here on an RS-232 port. And these four ports here can be used either as RS-232 or infrared. You can have up to two infrared devices on the same port. Then we have our relay ports, where we can attach either a simple relay or and two relays combined in a screen, where we can set up the screen up and down time and the block time. Then we have all our in and outputs. In this case, we have an output here, which will be used for an alarm. We can enter a new name for our output right here. And we have a keyboard lock, which of course is used for as an input when to use the keyboard lock. Then we have a movement sensor, also an input, which you also can change the name of if you want to do that. Then we have an I/O keyboard, which is also using the I/Os. In this case, we have four buttons or four keys, and all of them supporting LED. So let's try to delete this one, and I can show you how to add an I/O keyboard again. Select this. We want, okay, in this case, two buttons. We want LED, and we can select what I/O port we want to use as the starting I/O. We simply just select OK, and then we got our I/O keyboard attached. For RS-232 devices, we have the possibility to click Edit Device, and when you do that, you must notice that it's only in this project the device is edited. So I'll tell you a little about our unit selector. We have several devices here, and you can choose what kind of device you want to show. In this case, we just select all of them, and you can see we have amplifier, CD player, and so on. We can click on one of these. We have a Needs amplifier, and we can simply just drag it onto our project diagram like this, and it's attached here, and you can change settings for that specific device if you like that. Then we have the Needs part, where we have all our Needs devices on the PC. It's just a shortcut to finding the Needs products. Then we have the miscellaneous part, where we, as shown before, can attach keyboards or keyboard lock or screens and so on. So for the control system itself, we have some settings for that as well. We can change the name or location, and this name and location you will see when you make a LAN lookup. We can try to do that. Let's see if we have anything on the network. We have two Zulu connected on the network, and we can see the name is just Zulu 1, and we have the location right here, and that's the location you specify here. And when you are finished, you simply proceed attaching sequences from all the devices onto your buttons and keys. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial.